story in particular that always sticks out in my mind. It was a service like this. I'm gonna have Joe come up. He's gonna be me. I was about his age. Jude, sorry. There's a lot of jizz. Thanks, Jude. Thanks for being a trooper. So I'm an evangelist, right? As a kid, I was in a lot of revival services. I grew up under the pews, watching people pass out in front of here, being baptized. That was my childhood. So then he called people up, and he said, you know, come up if you want that baptism of the Holy Spirit. So I'm about his age, and I said, I'm scared. So what I did is I snuck through the pews into the back. I said, I'm safe. I'm good. There's something scared about this. Something scary. And he says, so I want you to go hide there in the back. You're me. You're me right now. Go hide in the back. And he says, you know what? Something's stirring. I need somebody to go check the back. There's somebody missing up here. And I said, oh no. So we had a balcony like that, but there was it was bigger. And there you are. So, but there's two exits. So I book up into the balcony and I'm hiding up there. So okay, now I'm good. I'm slick. So you don't have to go all the way up there, buddy. But you can just picture him up there, and he goes, you know what? There's somebody in the balcony. I need you to go search the balcony. I was the only one up there, and I was hiding. He didn't see anybody. He knew. God was telling him. So at that point, God was chasing me. He said, I have something for you. I'm chasing you. But I didn't receive because I was afraid. And I ran. And that's the course of my life. I ran into the bathroom. He said, so I'm going to the balcony. She went to the side. I know. I could tell. Okay, which side's going to come? Because there's two entrances. If she goes this way, I can book out that way. So I ran into the bathroom and I hid. And that's just kind of like the theme of my life, of God just constantly pursuing me. So you would think I'm matured since that point, you know? You know, like I'm a grown man now. I should just continue. God set me on the straight and narrow with those experiences, and I'm on the straight and narrow now. Well, even this, I haven't told Pastor John a story yet, so this is going to be a surprise to him. Even most recently, I come to visit. He's telling me about how I came to visit, and as I was leaving, he gave me a path. He gave me directions to Eliana's. He gave me $5. You got to try Eliana's. You never tried Eliana's? Go to Eliana's. Okay. So I follow his directions, and I'm at Eliana's. So I put in my map just in case. I'm not really good with directions. I've never been here before. I'm gonna get lost. I go straight towards I-10. It's just like this, like, I don't know what it is, but something in me always wants a shortcut and always save time. So I'm on this path and I see this road cut that way. And I said, why go straight and that way? And then I can go that way. So just out of my pride, I take a right, away from Pastor John's instructions and his wisdom, away from the maps that knew where I was supposed to go. I went to the right, because I think I know where I'm going, I got this. So it cuts through some trails, you're out in the middle of nowhere. And I knew that my tires weren't that great, I needed to get new tires. I could probably get a flat out here, no cell phone service. Why am I doing this? It's okay. I'm coming up to I-10. It'll be fine. I'll get on. And then right before I get there, I said, you know what? What if there's no on-ramp? There wasn't an on-ramp. Woo! Right over. I'm like, yep, I'm supposed to go that way. Here I go. And then so I keep going and I keep going. And there's something about obedience. Obedience is the love language to God. Obedience is our love language, because I didn't stay on my path. He knows my direction. He lights my path. And many times we stray for for pride, for fear. We run. So I'm going to talk about that. Maybe there's some reasons why I'm running. And I knew that God always had a call in my life, and I always took alternative paths. And I think it's just all the wasted time. And what God could have done, what God could do through each of you. And you might be straying away from your path. You might have just a clear-cut path that's cut out for you, that God laid upon you. And for your own pride and stubbornness, you take it right. So let's just pray for surrender and this morning before I get in. And just pray for obedience and surrender. Lord, we come to you and we give our all. We know that you are constantly chasing us. You constantly light a path. Let us have faith in you. Because if faith was easy, we'd be doing it. It's not comfortable. If it's not comfortable, it's not faith. If it's what we feel like, if it's possible, we would do it, but it's impossible, so we run. Let us trust in you while you lead us through our path, Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus' name. So